In this video of WCF, we will cover the duplex message pattern exchange. Now, unlike to the previous pattern, here the communication will take place in both the directions. That is, the client will call some of the service method, and then in return, the service will also give some kind of data or information to the client. So basically, the message here is sent in both the direction. The client calls the method of the service. Like for example, the client clicked a button which is invoking any of the method of the service. Here we will not consider the method will be returning a void, rather it will return some value. So let's take an example that message is giving me, the method is giving me a large amount of JSON data. Now, being a client, I will not wait for the data, but somewhere around I want a notification or any progress that how much data is being downloaded. So for this particular purpose, we will require a callback function, which we will define as a callback in the operation contract method. And in return, this service use the client callback function to call the method in the client to tell like how much downloading or how much copying of data is done. So let's start the implementing the duplex message pattern exchange, and we'll see how to pass that callback function thing in the request reply pattern of WCF. So let's start the implementation now.
Now, to implement the duplex message exchange pattern in WCF, I have taken a new project in which there is an interface called iProcess, which will be undergoing through some process. Whatever you wish, you can define the definition of this particular method accordingly. And here, what I'll have to do is I will have to pass the attribute service contract as we used to do. Alright, and inside this, we'll define the operation contract as many as you want with some definitions. Alright, now here you can find the same process, like there is a process class which is implementing this iProcess interface, and this task process method is actually going through some big process. As you can see, there's 100 times this loop is running, and every time I'm making a pause of 50 milliseconds. Now, since here we want to implement the duplex message exchange pattern, there must be something which should return the status updates. For example, if this particular process is done with 10%, 20%, 50% or 100%, I want some information should be there on the client end so that it can get like how much the process is done. So to implement that particular scenario, I will have to go through something right here, and the thing which we are going to implement here is the callback method. So for implementing this callback method, what we will do, we will add a new interface in this particular project. As here you can see, I have added one more interface, iProcess callback, which is not having any service contract, it is not required. And inside this, there's a method called task progress, which will be containing the parameter called in%done. Since it is a callback thing, this interface, so this method parameter will give you the value like how much of the process is actually done. And to specify its reference, this callback interface reference here in this service contract, we will add the parameter callback contract. And with inside this, I will pass this particular name. So this particular interface will now be responsible for the callback thing. And whenever it is required to tell the status of a particular process done to the client, we will use this particular callback interface with the method called task progress, which will give you the percentage done status. And now one small change will be there in the method definition when you are giving the pause. Since here I'm using the callback thing, so here I'll use operation contract, which you will find inside service model. So the current callback channel will be going through this iProcess callback, and inside this you will get the task progress method. As you can see, there's a task progress method in which the percentage done will be specified. So here what I have done, I have passed i. which is here in this particular method, which will give you the status of the particular process, like whether this loop is executed for 1, 2, 3, 4 or whatever times. All right. So here I have deliberately written this loop from 1 to 100 so that I'll get the proper information, like it is done for 1%, 2% or how many percent. All right. So now this is how I have already defined the service here, and in the same process, in the same solution, I have added the host application as well, which is nothing but a console application, where in the app.config I have already done the configurations regarding the WCF services, which we have already discussed in our previous video. As you can see, there is a net TCP binding, so I'll be implementing this net TCP binding with this duplex. There are few bindings which does not support the duplex, but net.tcp binding will support you for the duplex message exchange pattern as well. And after that, there is a program.cs inside which I have just initialized the service host, and it is open, and I'll give you a message that is server running. All right, so let's start this server. All right. Now, as you can see, the server is running. So now let's get started with the host the client application. And for the client application, what I have done here is I have already taken the Windows application here, in which it's a very simple design out here. There's a progress bar and there is a start task button. So as soon as I will click on this, the progress, the percentage completed done will be shown in this progress bar. Alright, so let's see what I have done inside this. First of all, I'll take the instance context class, which will be there in the service model namespace, and along with that I have also added the reference for this duplex WCF service. Alright, so we know like how to add the reference. For that, we'll right click over the references, we'll come to service reference, and here in the server application, I have specified the path and the root location out here in this app.config file. So you can simply use this particular path here, you say go, and likewise you will get the references. I just renamed that with the name called duplex WCF service. So I have added the reference for the both duplex WCF services as well as for the service model. What I have done, when you click the button, this context class, instance context class is initialized, and since the current instance, that is this particular form, is running the particular instance of the WCF service, so I have just passed this inside, and this is the proxy class which will be generated by the time you will add the reference. So process client client is equal to new process client, and inside this I have passed this context object. And after that, you can easily call the task process. But apart from that, I have done one more change here in this particular project, that is this form class, which by default is derived from this form class only. Here I have also implemented the iProcess callback, and let's remember, what is this iProcess callback? It is the interface which was responsible for the callback activity. And when you will start defining this callback interface out there, so you will have to define the task progress method as well. And right here you can see the task progress method is being defined with the same parameter int percent done, and whatever percent done will be there, it will be set for the progress bar value. So server instance is already running. Let's click here in the start button and see what is going on. So basically here you can get the error, that is the operation would deadlock because the reply cannot be received until message completes processing. Alright, so for that, what we have to do, we have to make the changes in the concurrency mode to re-entrant. Alright, so let's do that. For that, just let me stop the server instance, and then we'll come back to the service, and here in the class, what we will do, we will say service behavior, and here what we'll say, we'll say the concurrency mode is equal to concurrency mode dot re-entrant. So this is the first change that you will have to make for making the change in the concurrency mode that you will have to do in the class where you are actually defining your service. And the second change you will have to make in the another instance of the Visual Studio, that is where your client application is running. And here what you will have to do is you will pass the attribute called callback behavior, and here you will have to set use synchronization context to false. Alright, so let's execute your server and client application both now. So first of all, I will execute my server instance. Now it is started. Let's come to the client. Alright, so here you are getting an error called cross-thread operation not valid. Alright, because it's a single threaded application when you're working in Windows application. So you'll have to just make some changes out there for the controls if you are using, since here we are using the Windows application where there could be some threads which may be working with some different threads. The different control may work on different threads. Alright, so since here I'm working with progress bar, so what I'll do here is I'll say progress bar dot check for cross thread illegal cross thread calls is equal to false. Alright, so let's execute it again. First of all, again I'll start with the server. So let's start it first. Alright, it's running now. Let's come to the client application. I click on start task, and you can see this progress bar here is working. Alright, so this is how you can start working with the duplex message exchange pattern in WCF.